The next test in the VNG test battery is the gaze test. The gaze test doesn't require the cover on the goggles because we're going to ask the patient to look at a target on the screen. So Tess, during this test, what I'm going to do is ask you to look at the target on the screen. That target is going to move leftwards, rightwards, upwards, and downwards. All you need to do is to, as soon as the target moves, follow it with your eyes and keep looking at that target whilst it's in that position. Okay. What will happen is we'll stop after 12 seconds and then we'll move on to the next position. So I'll instruct you as we go through the test which direction to look at. Okay. Any questions before we begin?
No.
Fantastic. So let's start the test. So if I can ask you to have a look at the center dot for me, please. Eyes open, and here we go.
Counting down from 12. Zero.
Fantastic. Okay, so what's going to happen this time is the target's going to move to the left. And I want you to follow your eyes, follow that target with your eyes.
Counting down from 12.
Okay, looking at the center dot and to the left. On the graph, what we can see is a yellow line representing the target moving, and the red and the blue lines representing the right eye and the left eye. Okay, we're going to move on to the next condition where the target's going to move to the right. So again, if you can look at the center dot for me, eyes open, and here we go.
Counting down from 12.
If there was any nystagmus seen on this test, we would see it on the average slow phase velocity graph on the right-hand side of the screen. Okay, doing really well, Tess. What we're going to do now is to make the target move upwards. So, here we go, looking at the center dot.
Counting down from 12.
Fantastic. With top positions, or the vertical positions, we move the eyes 20 degrees, whereas in the horizontal positions, we move the eyes 30 degrees. Let's finish the gaze test by looking at the downwards position. And again, as this is a vertical test, we're going to be looking 20 degrees downwards. Okay, looking at the center dot, please, for me, Tess, and here we go.
Counting down from 12. Zero.
Excellent. So now that the test is finished, I can say to you, Tess, you can relax, close your eyes, whilst I have a quick look at the results screen. What we can see is the results for all five gaze positions, and as I mentioned before, if there was any nystagmus present, this would be extracted and displayed in each of the average slow phase velocity graphs, which can be seen to the right of each test. So this is an example of an abnormal gaze test. What we can see is that when the patient's looking in the center conditions and to the right, there isn't any gaze-evoked nystagmus. However, when they look towards the left, we can see a significant gaze evoked nystagmus, which only occurs during the beginning part of the gaze. And this has then therefore been repeated, and we can see that that's consistent across two different test conditions. This is an example of a patient which then, over further testing, revealed to have a central disorder. This concludes the gaze test, and now we can move on to the next test within our VNG test battery.